All right.
I love show business.
So we're on.
They're doing it with a... We're on?
Yeah, we're on.
Okay,
we're going. Okay. So, hello, everybody. We're here coming to you from Hispanicize. We're with Campbell McLaren.
Hola.
And Campbell is a co-founder of UFC.
Absolutely.
And now he is the CEO of Combate Americas. And I had not heard of Combate Americas, so Campbell, would you tell us what Combate Americas is? And I'm a fight fan.
You need to know.
I need to know, so please educate me and tell me what it is.
Well, Combate Americas is the first Hispanic MMA franchise ever. So all our fighters are Hispanic, everything done in Spanish, Spanish celebrities, Spanish music, and most of all, Spanish fight style. Because it's all about corazon. You have to fight with heart, right? And there's certain fighters, I don't want to pick on anyone, Floyd Mayweather, that fights moving backwards. My guys and girls don't fight moving backwards. They fight coming forward. So I often say, you know, more salsa sold in the U.S. than ketchup. Not because there's more Spanish people, because everybody likes Spanish flavor. So Combate Americas is mixed martial arts, Spanish flavor. And it's a blast. It's unbelievable fun. You know, it's just super entertaining and great.
Let's talk about why it's fun, but before, let's stick to the fight.
Just because
it's more boxing fight doesn't mean that you don't get a round kick to the head.
Absolutely,
or a side kick.
No.
There's a little bit of everything.
No. It's mixed martial arts, and mixed martial arts means mixed martial arts. So you're going to see jiu-jitsu, you're going to see judo, you will see a little karate because that's a little more in the movies, but you'll see Muay Thai fighting, and of course our guys are good boxers, so you're going to see a lot of punching. Good punchers in Combate Americas.
Corazón, passion, that's what Hispanics are known for. So it's fun. It's not only because of the intensity of the fight, but why else it's fun? You talked about Chino, Nacho.
Well, it's the music, it's the mix, and it's just the vibe. And I'll tell you, we have a great fighter named Ricky Palacios, who's known as El Gallero. And when he comes into the fight, he brings in all the ladies in his life. And that includes his wonderful wife and his daughters and everybody else. Because Combate Americas, like anything Hispanic, is a family affair.
It's a telenovela.
So it's a telenovela with real fighting in it.
So I asked you.
I like that line. That's a good line. Yeah.
There you go. You can use it.
Thank you.
You have my permission.
Thank you. That's
online. Good. I have a question for you. Why Combate America and not keeping these Hispanics fighting within the UFC realm? Was there a need? Was there an opportunity to highlight? And the other question was, have you found that fighting is natural to the Hispanic audience, or is it something like with the USTA where they're reaching out to Hispanics to bring them into tennis, which wasn't a natural sport for them?
Yeah, no, two good questions. So there were not enough Hispanic fighters in the UFC, and I don't think they were putting a lot of effort into it. A lot of Brazilian fighters, but not Hispanic. So I thought that was important to give this opportunity. And no, I think that Hispanic fighters are perfect because it's part of the culture, it's the passion, and it's a boxing. Boxeo is the Hispanic martial art. So you've got a great boxing tradition, and that really translates to the mixed martial arts very well.
And we talked
about... Good question! Well, you're an expert!
I told you I'm a fighter!
I'm a fighter,
I get very passionate about this, which is exactly what you want to channel into Combate America.
Absolutely.
Right? We talked about how it would be natural that UFC would have included Brazilian because of the Haiti tradition, maybe the capoeira as well.
More jiu-jitsu than capoeira. Capoeira is fun to watch, but I don't know if you can win a fight with capoeira.
It's an artistic form,
absolutely.
But they say that if you know your capoeira well, you can be quite deadly.
Yeah. Yes.
So tell me a little bit about this Monday night program.
Monday night, NBC Universo. We're going to be on at 9 p.m. Pacific time. We start April 18th, and we're just going to run on Monday nights. It's going to be a blast.
Do you have to buy a specific cable package to be able to watch this?
NBC Universo does have a channel finder, so if you go to their website, they can tell you. I think it depends on your cable system and depends with your direct or dish. Like if you have direct and you have dish, I think you automatically get it.
Well, Campbell,
sorry, I should know that.
But this is the age of Google.
That
you don't have the answer, it's
Google.
Just a few keys away.
Yeah.
So thank you for speaking with us. Thank you, my dear.
Great questions,
thank
great
you.
Interview.
Thank you. Thank you for creating Combate America.
Ah,
I'm
very
definitely going to follow up on this.
My pleasure.
Thank you.
Great.